La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. 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 الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وأزواجه وذرياته Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His mercy and through His grace, continually grants us blessed moments and also the opportunity to be in blessed places. And during blessed moments and during the time when we are in blessed places, through the blessedness of these moments and through the blessedness of these places, fulfilling the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and engaging in optional devotions, engaging in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, engaging in dua and supplication becomes easy. And also, a person is able to acquire the nearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more quickly. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has specified many amal for special moments and for special places for which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared much more virtues than when those amal are carried out during other moments or not in blessed places. Blessed places, masjid is a blessed place. So masjid is a more blessed place than when we are outside the masjid. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has said, أحب البلاد إلى الله مساجدها. Masajid are the most beloved portions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the surface of this earth. So masajid are very, very blessed. They are beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence, we should try our utmost to value the masajid and spend as much time as possible in the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should try our best to perform all our salat in the masjid and come as early as possible before the salat and stay for as long as possible after the salat, remaining engaged in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in tilawat, in dua, in nawafil, in other devotions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa is also very blessed. Similarly, a madrasa is more blessed than outside. Our homes, where we spend most of our times, and if our homes are full of taqwa, if disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is refrained from, then they are also blessed in comparison to what is outside. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for this reason has said, وَلْيَسَاكَ بَيْتُكَ. When Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ نَجَاتَ. What is the path to salvation? How can I acquire salvation? How can I escape from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What do I need to do? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned three things. أَمْلِكَ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ. Have complete control over your tongue. Make sure that your tongue does not go in the wrong direction. It always remains on the path that takes a person to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your tongue should not make any mistake. So have complete control over your tongue. Think before you speak. Think very carefully before you speak. Number two, وَلْيَسَاكَ بَيْتُكَ. And make sure that your house remains spacious for you. That means you find comfort in remaining in your house. Remain within the confines of your home as much as possible. Do not leave your home without dire necessity, without any necessity. And number three, وَبْكِ عَلَىٰ خَطِيَتِكَ. And cry over your mistake. Weep over your mistake. If you make a mistake, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are able to weep with your heart and the mind, heart and the eyes, and if the eyes cannot shed tears, at least feel the grief of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and weep with your heart. So from amongst the three deeds that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has directed Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu anhu towards for salvation in the hereafter, for escaping from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one is wal yasaka baytuk. Why? Because a muttaqi's home, a home of a muttaqi is a blessed place. It is a place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be disobeyed. It is a place where five times salat will be performed. It is a place where tilawah will take place. It is a place where the household will wake up for tahajjud salah. It is a place where the family will engage in learning and teaching. So it is a blessed place also in comparison to the marketplaces, in comparison to the environment outside. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa is very blessed. And Al-Masjid al-Nabawi is even more blessed. And Al-Masjid al-Haram in Makkah Mukarrama is even more blessed. So we should try our utmost to benefit from, we should try our utmost to spend as much time as possible in blessed places. And we should try our utmost to benefit as much as possible from blessed places. Similarly, blessed moments. रमजान मुबारक, ब्लेसिड, वेरी ब्लेसिड मंथ रमजान मुबारक. एंड the nights of Ramadan Mubarak in the last 10 days even more blessed, mashallah. The days of Eid and the nights of Eid, blessed moments, alhamdulillah. The day of Friday, blessed. We get this opportunity every seventh day. Every seventh day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us a very very blessed day, which is the day of Friday, and for 24 hours. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has said that any optional deed carried out on the day of Friday is equivalent to 70 deeds carried out on days other than Friday. Aw kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. It is for this reason, if the day of Arafah falls on a Friday, then those performing Hajj during that year become very happy, because they feel that they are very lucky and they are very fortunate to be performing Hajj that year, because their Hajj will be multiplied by 70. And because when the day of Arafah falls on a Friday, a person is rewarded with a Hajj multiplied by 70. So Hajj performed on a Friday is equal to 70 Hajj performed on days other than Friday. The Awamun Nas, the people, the masses, they say that alhamdulillah, when I performed Hajj, it was Hajji Akbar. It was a big Hajj. Big Hajj, the meaning of big Hajj is that they call it big Hajj because the reward was great. The reward was enormous. The reward was multiplied by 70. Whereas in the Shari terminology, every Hajj is Hajji Akbar. Hajji Akbar means the major Hajj, the great Hajj. And Hajj is called Hajji Akbar in relation to Umrah, which is Hajji Asghar. So Hajji Asghar is the minor pilgrimage and Hajji Akbar is the major pilgrimage. So every Hajj is Hajji Akbar. But the people normally say, oh, this year is going to be Hajji Akbar. There is a possibility that Hajj is going to be Hajji Akbar. This is not Shari terminology, but they call it Hajji Akbar because when Hajj falls on a Friday, if the day of Arafah falls on a Friday and you're performing Hajj that year, then your Hajj will be 70 times much more virtuous. So the day of Friday is very, very virtuous. So just as our amal increase during the month of Ramadan in relation to the remaining 11 months, each and every person should feel on a Friday that my amal has increased on Friday in relation to the remaining the other 6 days of the week. So Friday is a blessed day. Then there are numerous blessed moments that come throughout the year, blessed days, blessed nights, blessed moments. When we are in the masjid, the place is blessed and the moments are blessed also. When a person is performing salat, it is a blessed moment. When the khutbah is taking place on Friday, it is a blessed moment. The time between azan and iqamat is a blessed moment also. And from amongst these blessed moments and blessed days and blessed nights that we encounter during the whole year, the first 10 days of Zulhijjah are very, very precious. They are from the most precious moments, the first 10 days of Zulhijjah. And if I am correct, then the first 10 days of Zulhijjah will either begin on Saturday or Sunday. Friday or Saturday. So, if we don't get the result of the moon sighting on Thursday, then assuming that it could be the first day of Zulhijjah and it is already a blessed day, so it will have double blessings. Because it is the day of Friday and it could be the first of Zulhijjah. So we need to make a timetable for these 10 days and start following that timetable with extra care, with extra ibadat from this coming Thursday evening, from the Maghrib of Thursday, because there is a possibility that Friday could be the first of Zulhijjah. And if Friday is not the first of Zulhijjah, then Saturday is definitely first of Zulhijjah. And for 10 days, we need to do as much ibadat as possible, beginning from the first of Dhul-Hijjah. This is the 12th month of the Islamic calendar. So beginning from the first of Dhul-Hijjah, taking it all the way up to the day of Eid. Enjoy yourself on the day of Eid. Eat good, wear good, enjoy yourself, remaining within Sharia limits. But one should also remember that the night of Eid and the day of Eid are from amongst the blessed moments. So I need to engage in ibadat also. We should not only go through the checklist on the day of Eid. Checklist means Maghrib Salat is first, so I have to. Isha Salat is first, so I have to. What is necessary for Maghrib? 3 rakat farz and 2 rakat sunnat. Done. 4 rakat farz of Isha, 2 rakat sunnat, 3 rakat wajib, done. No. We should increase on the night of Eid. And on the night of Eid, we should try to remain in masjid at least between Maghrib and Isha. At least between Maghrib and Isha. After Isha also for 5-10 minutes. Perform at least 4 rakat, 6 rakats, 8 rakats, Salatul Tahajjud. Then go to sleep, wake up for Fajr Salat. Wake up for Fajr Salat and make sure you perform Fajr Salat also because it's day of Eid. And then following the Sunan of Eid, perform the Eid Salat also. And during the day also, do both. Like in the month of Ramadan, we enjoy as well. We enjoy at the time of Iftar. Everybody looks forward to Iftar. They eat good food at Iftar. But they don't become negligent in the month of Ramadan. Whilst enjoying the food between Maghrib and Isha, the mind and the eyes are always towards the watch and the clock. Because I have to go and perform Isha Salat. I have to perform Taraweeh Salat. So they rush very quickly after Maghrib Salat. And despite rushing after Maghrib Salat, those who are particular, they will make sure that they perform 2 rakat sunnah, 2 rakat nafal, 2 rakat extra to make it Salatul Awwabin. And they will try to, they will have good food, enjoy food. And nice cup of tea if they need to. They will relax and have a cup of tea. But their eyes are set on the clock. And many people will try to come into the masjid early so they are able to engage in some ibadat before Isha Salat also. So both things remain in the mind at the time of Iftar. I want to enjoy Iftar also because good food is cooked. I want to enjoy Iftar also, but I want to be back for Isha Salat. I don't want to be late. I don't want to miss Taraweeh. I don't want to miss my Isha Salat. Similarly, on the day of Eid also, enjoy the feast, enjoy the get-togethers, enjoy meeting each other, greeting each other. But at the same time, remember your faraiz, remember your wajibat, remember abstaining from haram, abstaining from makruhati tahrimiya, abstaining from anything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember that it is a blessed day which will end at Maghrib time. So let me do some extra ibadat also. At least after every salat, sit in the masjid for 10 minutes, 5 minutes and carry out good deeds. So beginning from the first of Zulhijjah until the Maghrib on the day of Eid, these moments are blessed and we need to value them more. Value them more. Engage in extra ibadat. And as far as the 9th of Zulhijjah is concerned, the day before the day of Eid, which is called the day of Arafah, it is even more blessed. So we should engage more in ibadat during the night of Arafah and the day of Arafah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has said in a hadith that the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah are so blessed in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that every day is equivalent to 1,000 days. So if we perform 2 rakat extra on each of these days, or just one of these days, then it is like performing 2 rakats on 1,000 days. Performing 2 rakat during one of these days is like performing 2 rakat during 1,000 days. And if you perform 2 rakat extra during all the 10 days of Zulhijjah, it is like performing 2 rakat for 10,000 years. And the day of Arafah is equivalent to 10,000 days. So performing 2 rakat on the day of Arafah is equivalent to 10,000 days. So basically, if you perform 2 rakat, it is like performing 2 rakat on 9,000 years, 19,000 years. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also said that anyone who fasts on the day of Arafah, then his minor and major sins of the past, his minor sins of the past and the coming year will be forgiven. So we should value these 10 days and try to perform as much ibadah as possible. And also those of us who are able to sacrifice an animal for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these days, we should try to sacrifice an animal also. If it is wajib upon us, try to take a leaflet titled Udhiyah. And by reading that title, you will know whether Udhiyah or Qurbani or animal sacrifice is wajib upon you or not. If it is wajib, then we have to carry out that obligation. But even if it is not wajib, we should still try to, if we are able to, if we have the means, then we should still try to sacrifice an animal on the day of Eid. And those of us who are able to sacrifice more than one animal, we should try to sacrifice as many as possible. What we can do is, we can sacrifice animals in those areas where Muslims are poor and the meat can be distributed there amongst them. There are areas in many places throughout the world where Muslims live and they only get to eat meat on the day of Eid, on the day of Eidul Adha. That is how poor they are. But whilst trying to facilitate for such people, we should make a point of slaughtering and at least one animal in our homes. So we are able to partake of the meat of our own sacrificed animal. So try to sacrifice as many animals as possible during the days of Udhiyah. There are many virtues for sacrificing Udhiyah also, and takbirat of tashrik. Takbirat of tashrik, we should try to perform all our 5 times salat regularly with jamaat during the days of tashrik and outside the day of tashrik also. But in particular during the days of tashrik, we should participate and audibly we should say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. All brothers are encouraged, and sisters also, to benefit from these 3 leaflets published by the Islamic Dawah Academy. Significance of the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, and the other is Udhiyah, animal sacrifice, Qurbani. And the third is the day of Eidul Adha. The brothers can take these leaflets from the back, and sisters can ask their men folk to take these leaflets from here, and all can benefit from the Islamic Dawah Academy website also. Islamic Dawah Academy and also At-Tazkiyah. So IDAUK.org and At-Tazkiyah.com. So try to benefit and follow the instructions. These days will come and they will go away. And once they are gone, we will not be able to do anything. And shaitan will put these thoughts in our minds. Okay, I'll start from tomorrow. So if the first day is, say, Friday, Shaitan will say, nafs will say, from tomorrow. Comes Saturday, inshallah, I'll do something tomorrow. Still got 8 more days left. And soon we will know that we are on the day of Arafah. On the day of Arafah also, we will not be able to do anything. Eid again, we will not be able to do anything. Because Shaitan will start whispering, oh, you're still young, you are still healthy. You'll get many more 10 days of Zulhijjah. And who knows, before the next month of Zulhijjah, you may depart from this world. So make the most out of the opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all acceptance. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Allahumma laka alhamdu kama anta ahluh. Wa salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammadin kama anta ahluh. Wa fa'al bina ma anta ahluh. فإنك أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم بارك لنا فيما عطيتنا وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت لنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا تنزع منا صالح ما عتيتنا اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثارنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مسيرنا واجعل الجنة هي دارنا اللهم احفظ الحرمين الشريفين والمسجد الأقصى المبارك واجعل اللهم آمنة مطمئنة وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم أنقذ إخواننا المسلمين المظلومين في كل مكان وفي فلسطين اللهم انصرهم ولا تنصر عليهم اللهم امكر لهم ولا تمكر عليهم اللهم زدهم ولا تنقصهم ولا تسلط عليهم من لا يرحمهم ولا يخافك فيهم اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا اللهم إنا نسألك حسن الختام والعفو عما سلف وكان يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين Shower your mercies upon us. O Arhamur Rahimeen, shower your mercies upon us. O the most merciful one, shower your mercies upon us. O the most forgiving, forgive our sins. O the most forgiving, forgive our sins. O Ghafoor, O Rahim, O Rahman, O Ghaffar, O Ghafir, forgive our sins. Forgive our sins, forgive the sins of our parents, our children, our families, our dear and near ones, and forgive the sins of the whole Ummah. O Allah, forgive the sins of the whole Ummah. Forgive the sins of the whole Ummah, including the deceased. O Arhamur Rahimeen, forgive our minor sins, forgive our major sins. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us all the ability and the tawfiq and the divine guidance to remain steadfast on the straight path. O Arhamur Rahimeen, incline our hearts towards good. Yadahal Alameen, disincline our hearts from bad and evil. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to do good and grant us the tawfiq to stay away from wrong. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the goodness of this world and the hereafter. And O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us safety from the evils of this world and the hereafter. O Arhamur Rahimeen, enlighten our hearts with your love. Enlighten our hearts with the love of your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Enlighten our hearts with love for Islam. O Arhamur Rahimeen, enlighten our hearts with your kalam, the Quran-e-Majeed. or our, I mean, grant us all the tawfiq to emulate your beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Wa arhamur rahimeen. For as long as you keep us in this world, keep us steadfast on the straight path. And when you take us from this world, take us with iman. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Take us from this world with iman. Take us from this world with iman. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Call us from this world whilst the kalima, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah is emanating from our tongues. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Make all the stations of the journey of the hereafter easy for us. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Grant us Jannatul Firdaus. Save us from the fire of Jahannam. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Fulfill all our lawful needs of this world and the hereafter. Wa arhamur rahimeen. Grant complete shifa and complete cure to our sick. Wa arhamur rahimeen. All those who are in difficulties, remove their difficulties. O Arhamur Rahimeen, O Arhamur Rahimeen. All those people who are facing oppression, remove oppression from them. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant them comfort, peace. O Arhamur Rahimeen, O Arhamur Rahimeen, O Arhamur Rahimeen. Every good that your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam has seek from you, grant it to us. O Arhamur Rahimeen, O Arhamur Rahimeen. Every evil from which your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam has seek refuge, grant us refuge from it. O Arhamur Rahimeen. Forgive the sins of our parents, our asatida, our mashayikh, and all those people who have conferred favors upon us. O Arhamur Rahimeen. Accept our prayers and supplications. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbi ighfir warham wa anta khairur rahimeen. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين.